Brad, good afternoon and welcome to a windy afternoon here at Bobcat Stadium in San Marcos, Texas. Cable Channel 7 presents another edition of Sam Houston State University Football. Today it's the Bearcats and the Southwest Texas State Bobcats. Hello again, everyone. I'm Rod Sydlik. Alongside me today, Jim Dillon. And Jim, a very important game today for Sam Houston.
Very important. If they want to get in the 1AA playoffs, they must win this game today against Southwest Texas. They are 7-3 on the season, 4-1 in Southland Conference play. They have a chance at the Southland Conference Championship, a three-way tie. They win this game today, and Northeastern Louisiana loses tonight at Arkansas State. Of course, you'll know the outcome of it as you are watching the game on the tape delayed basis, but the Bearcats have a very good chance to tie for the Southland Conference Championship, but they need to come out here and they need to establish a victory today. Southwest Texas is on a personal four-game winning streak itself. They are 4-6 on the season, 2-3 in Southland Conference play, but the rumor is going around that John O'Hara must win the day. He must beat Sam Houston State or his job is in serious jeopardy.
You're mentioning Southwest Texas head coach John O'Hara. He's in his fifth season with the Bobcats as their head coach, and to date he has posted a 27-27 record, including one Lone Star Conference championship and one Division II playoff berth. As you mentioned, the fourth straight win by Southwest Texas last week equals the best winning streak since 1984 for the Bobcats. The last time Southwest Texas won five straight was in 1983 when the Bobcats opened their season with five consecutive victories.
Bearcats are coming off a very impressive win over Western Illinois, who was ranked 19th in the nation, 42-18. Reggie Lewis had a good game. Luther Turner tied a Southland Conference record held by Buford Jordan, formerly of McNeese State, playing for the San Diego Chargers at 18 touchdowns on the season. He needs one more to break that record. He has 108 points on the season. He needs two more points, or the equivalent of one touchdown, to break that same record by Buford Jordan.
And there's going to be, we'll keep you up to date, but there's a lot of Southland Conference and Sam Houston State University football records that could go down during this afternoon's game. There's a whole list of them, and we'll keep you updated as to the records being set, but a lot of anticipation for this game as the Bearcats come out on the field. We should have a good one here, but Jim, with this wind blowing, if you may be able to hear it, it could be a factor this afternoon.
Winds coming out of the south from the north at about 20 to 25 miles an hour. The only other game that I could compare this wind to was in Denton against North Texas State. Maybe not quite as brisky as the wind was there, but the wind will make a factor in this game. As we will see, as Southwest Texas will be kicking off with the wind, Bearcats will be going into the wind in this first quarter, so they need to establish field position and try to get some kind of scoring against this wind in the first quarter.
Yeah, as you mentioned, the North Texas game, Reggie Lewis having a lot of trouble throwing the football against the wind in that game, suffered a few interceptions. So we'll just have to see. As you mentioned, Bearcats will be going against the wind here in the first quarter.
Reggie's arm not as strong as Coach Randleman would like. Brian Osterhaus probably a better thrower into the wind. You might see Coach Randleman in the first quarter stick to the run, give it to Luther, and give it to James Shorts, who will be starting in place of Daryl Montgomery, who is lost for the season. James Shorts will start at the fullback position. See a lot of substituting between Shorts, Adnan Dow, and Bubba Shaw. Those three should be alternating throughout the game today.
And as you mentioned, Brian Osterhaus may see some action. We mentioned that during the North Texas game, we were wondering with the stiff wind and the strong arm of Brian Osterhaus, would he come into the football game? We never saw him in the North Texas game. We may see him this afternoon.
Well, if you remember last year, the Bearcats were down 31-10 to Southwest Texas in the fourth quarter. All their hopes and dreams are going right down the drain, and then a backup quarterback named Brian Osterhaus came in the game, engineered a come-from-behind victory, 32-31. You know the Bobcats remember that last year, and they want revenge today.
David Haas's kickoff will be taken at the goal line, fumbled by Ricky Davis. He will return over the 15, and a nice open field tackle that time by Southwest Texas. Number 16 for Southwest Texas, Eugene Rogers, a backup quarterback, up to make the stop. For that time, Ricky Davis had a lot of green in front of him.
That was the only man that was between Ricky Davis and the goal line. All he had to do was get by that one man, and he had a lot of open room to go down the field and score. That one tackle right there saved a sure Bearcat touchdown because that was the only man left.
The Bearcats will come out on offense with Reggie Lewis at quarterback. James Shorts is the fullback, and Luther Turner dots the I at fullback. Double wide receivers, Henry and Lewis to the left. Now Henry comes in motion near side of the field, handed off to the deep back. Turner hit in the backfield, and he will just get back to the line of scrimmage.
Ernie Powell on the tackle there for Southwest Texas. The main goal of that is try to get Ernie Powell, get the running back to go by Ernie Powell on the game, on the play. But the only thing is Powell saw the play developing, and he saw Luther coming in and dropped it for a loss on the play.
Okay, officially no gain on the play. Brings up a second out and 10. Spot the ball out at the 23-yard line. Now Keith Willis comes out of the ballgame, and the Bearcats go with the double tight end set. Lone wide receiver to the near side is Victor Henry. Now pitch it deep in the backfield to Luther Turner. Looks for a block, gets outside across the 30. He will be close to a Bearcat first down.
Looks like he's going to pick it up, Rod. Nice play, nice run outside by Luther Turner. You can see Southwest Texas stacks that defensive line up front. It's going to be tough to run on because you stack all those defensive linemen up there. They control the run real good. Southwest Texas, they do have an Achilles heel. They are very easy to throw against, but you won't see Randall probably trying to throw the ball in the first quarter. So it's going to be tough grinding here for the Bearcats because they're probably going to try to keep it on the ground. But as we said, Southwest Texas, you can be sure they're doing it right now. Again, they're stacking up that front line. It's going to be hard to run, especially up the middle.
Okay, once again, double tight end set, I formation, lone receiver out to the left side, handed off to the first back through, that's James Shorts. Good yardage out across the 40 to the 42. Tackle on the play by number 16, that's Eugene Rogers up from his cornerback spot.
Nice blocking by the offensive line on that play. They ran it right up the middle. I said they would have a hard time. Sure enough, James Shorts gets a good gain up the middle. The offensive line is going to be a definite key here in the first quarter. They're going to have to open up some walls for the running backs to go through. That was a good job there by the offensive line to open up the wall on that play.
So give him 7 yards, bring up a second down and 3 for Sam Houston. Now Lewis looks like a busted play, ducks it under and will be brought down. And that time really didn't look like that play developed very well at all, Jim.
Do not think it was a pass play, and I do not think it was a naked rollout by Reggie. It looked like he wanted to give the ball to Luther on the play. The only thing is Luther was about 8 yards to the side of him, and he looked around and said, Luther, what the heck are you doing over there? And then he tried to run with the football. And before he did that, there was about 5 Southwest Texas Bobcats around him.
So loss on the play, back to the 37-yard line. Bearcats faced with a 3rd-and-8 situation. Just underway, first quarter play. Split backs behind Reggie Lewis. Now we'll run the draw play to James Shorts. He will get out to the 40-yard line, but he will be about 5 yards short of the first down, and the punting unit will come on for Sam Houston.
So far, the first series of downs for the Bearcats, we've seen him keep it on the ground on every play. Because of that win is very strong. It's going to be tough for Reggie to throw the ball in the first quarter. They did establish some good running plays. They got some good gains. Just a busted play was a result of the ending of this drive right here. Hopefully, Barr can get off a good punt into the stiff wind.
49, A.J. Johnson, a junior, 2-year letterman out of San Antonio Clements, is back deep to receive the Bart Bradley punt. Against the wind, Bradley gets off a nice punt, drives Johnson back to the 20-yard line, now looking towards the sidelines, and he gets down the sidelines. Nobody's going to catch A.J. Johnson. He will be across into the end zone for the touchdown. It looked that time, Jim, like they had him stopped on the far sideline. Looked like Reginald Oakes was going to run him out of bounds, but he stayed in bounds and went all the way for the touchdown.
I don't know how you can explain it. A couple of missed tackles by the Bearcats special teams, and lo and behold, we're back to about the first 4 games of the year where the Bearcats special teams gave up a touchdown a game. And Dennis is not a good sign to start off the football game. A couple of missed tackles. A.J. Johnson kept it down the sidelines. Never did go out of bounds. 78 yards on the punt return by A.J. Johnson. And as a result, the Bobcats get a touchdown via the special teams. And that really does hurt the Bearcat momentum here. Southwest Texas definitely with the momentum right now.
The left-footed kicker, Kyle Matlock, puts the extra point attempt up and through. And with 12 minutes and 2 seconds to go here in the first quarter, a big shock for the Bearcats. Southwest Texas leads it 7-0.
If you want to get hurt by scoring points, you want the offense to do it to you. The Bobcat offense did not put up any points at all last week versus Stephen F. Austin. Ironically, the only touchdown the Southwest Texas scored was on a blocked field goal attempt in the fourth quarter, with Stephen F. Austin leading 3-0. A.J. Johnson recovered the blocked field goal and went 59 yards for the touchdown. So once again, the Bobcats have 2 touchdowns in their last 2 games, and both of them are by A.J. Johnson, a blocked field goal for a touchdown, and now a 78-yard punt return for a touchdown.
So David Haas has it teed up at the 35-yard line as Victor Henry and Ricky Davis will drop back in dual safety for Sam Houston. As 81 yards, the punt return for the touchdown for A.J. Johnson. So So 12 minutes, 2 seconds to go here. First quarter, Bobcat Stadium in San Marcos, Texas. Bearcats looking to get into the 1AA playoffs with their final regular season game of the season. Victor Henry from the 2 now looks for a hole, has the 20, now out across the 30 and will be run out of bounds on the near side by number 31, Butch Maywald.
Dangerous situation there to kick to Victor Henry, leading the nation in kickoff returns after the second game of the year against Montana State. Nobody was kicking the ball to Victor Henry. And here they go, kicking it to him. Well, they saw Ricky Davis almost break one. Sure enough, Victor Henry almost went all the way.
Yeah, they're going to bring that one back. Offsides is the indication against Sam Houston, and that's really unfortunate. Offsides on the kickoff return team.
That's a highly unusual penalty, and that's such a shame because the Bearcats had good field position to start it off for the offense, and that's what you want going into this win. So a second key blunder for the Bearcats here in the first quarter, and we haven't even played 5 minutes yet.
So David Haas will come back on, move the ball up to the 40-yard line, and he will re-kick it. So the Bearcats looking a bit lethargic coming out here in the first quarter, having troubles that plagued them early in the season on the specialty teams, and now they must move the ball against that stiff wind here in the first quarter.
One positive thing, though, when you have Reggie Lewis and that Bearcat offense with all the powerful skill position people, seven's really nothing because you feel like you're going to put close to 30 or 35 up on the board with this offensive unit.
You just don't want to let this Southwest Texas team get the momentum. Don't let them get too far ahead here in the first quarter. Now this kickoff with the wind will go out of the back of the end zone. And the Bearcats will come out on offense. First and 10 from the 20-yard line.
That's the best defense there against Victor Henry and Ricky Davis. You just kick it out of the end zone as hard as you can. That's why I didn't understand why Madlock didn't try to kick that ball out of the end zone. First of all, it looked like he was trying to kick it short on purpose to set up the return. But when you got Davis and Henry back there, that is not a very wise thing to do.
Victor Henry goes wide to the left side as the Bearcats stay with a double tight end set, as Rob Beecham is tight to the left side and Ricky Eggleston is tight to the right. I formation, shorts, and Turner pitch the ball deep in the backfield to Turner. He will get out across the 20 to about the 24-yard line. A pickup of about 4 yards on that play will bring up a second down and 6.
Bearcats rushing the ball in the first quarter. They need 194 yards rushing today to set a team record. The old team record was 2,542 yards for the 1954 Bearcat team. Presently, going into the game, they had 2,349, so we got to keep an eye on that, 194 yards.
James Lopez checks in at wide receiver. He will go wide to the left side as the Bearcats stay with the double tight end set. Second down and 6, ball at the 24-yard line. Hand it off, fullback shorts, now breaks a couple of tackles. He will be about 2 yards short of the first down. 4 yards on that carry.
Let's mention some of the other needs for the Bearcat offense today going into the game. Need 24 total yards for total offense in a season. The old record for the team was 4,529. They have 4,506. They've probably already broken that record. They're very close to it. We'll get to the others in a little bit.
Third and 2, ball spotted at the 28-yard line. Big play for Sam Houston to keep the drive alive. Pitch it deep in the backfield. Turner breaks a couple of tackles and will go out of bounds. We'll have enough for the first down. Driven out of bounds on the near sidelines by Andre Horton, the free safety.
Offensive line doing a good job blocking against that strong defensive front of Southwest Texas, providing good running room for James Shorts and Luther Turner. And that's what they're going to need in this first quarter because you know Randleman is going to keep it on the ground.
Taking a look at that Bearcat line, the right tackle is Jeff Kirby, right guard Floyd George. The center is Troy Coots, left guard David Elam, and the left tackle is Chris Herman. Ricky Eggleston is at tight end. Rob Beecham now also at tight end as the Bearcats go double tight. Hand the ball off to Turner. Now has a hole, will be out across the 40-yard line on the second and 10 carry.
Some more needs for the Bearcats this season. 489 yards total offense today will break a Southland Conference record. As we mentioned, they got 4,506. The old record's 4,994 yards by Abilene Christian in 1970. Need 4 touchdowns for most touchdowns in a season by a Southland Conference team. They have 48. The record's 51 by Abilene Christian, same year, 1970.
Victor Henry is wide to the left side. Second down and 5, ball at the 41, handed straight up the middle, fullback James Shorts, good yardage into Bobcat territory, Once again, number three, Andre Horton, the junior transfer from Austin Reagan, up to make the stop for Southwest Texas. And the free safety's making a lot of tackles here early for Southwest Texas.
Give credit to Kirby, George, Coons, David Elam, and also Chris Herman. They're doing the job up front, and that's what they're going to need in this first quarter because you know they're going to run it.
Well, when they go, when the Bearcats go with a double tight end set, that almost assuredly means run. Lopez is the lone wide receiver, but the Bearcats keep it on the ground at Turner. Now a flag is down as Turner bounces off a couple of tacklers. Once again, Andre Horton drags him out of bounds.
I think they're going to catch Jeff Kirby with a hold on that play number 76. It looked like he was dragging a defensive lineman down. I saw it, and also the official saw it too. So Marsh, the Bearcats back 10 yards. Kind of a bitter play there on first down.
So first down, and on the good first down play, now we'll put the ball back into Bearcat territory as they will spot it at the 41-yard line. The Bearcats now will scrimmage first and 20.
So far, second penalty for the Bearcats in the game for 15 yards. Southwest Texas played a clean game so far. Offense hasn't handled the ball yet.
So second, first down and 20, spot the ball at the 41-yard line. Handoff goes to the first back through. That's Shorts. And the junior one-year letterman from Huntsville gets about 3 yards on that carry. Still bring up a second down and long.
One positive note for the Bearcats, the fine defensive end for Southwest Texas, I don't know if you mentioned or not, Rod, Arnold Baker is not playing today. He is a stellar on that defensive line, but Baker has a knee injury and he has not played, but they still have Jimmy Nelms back there, who's tied for the Southland Conference lead in interceptions with 6, with who else? Mr. 85 himself, Billy Anderson, who's only played 4 games back at safety.
Now second down and 17, Keith Willis has checked in at a wide receiver. Straight back to throw is Reggie Lewis, swings it out. Luther Turner is met on the play. Nice play that time by number 16, Eugene Rogers, the junior 2-year letterman from Corsicana, up to make the stop for Southwest Texas.
Also, Brad Folks, the linebacker, came over on the play. Good pursuit there by Southwest Texas. They read the screen to Luther. It was almost a lateral on the play. It was that close, but they read it. The pursuit did well, and they came over and they got Luther for just a short gain. Reggie's got to put it up in the air here on third down.
Third down and 17. Split backs behind the quarterback, Reggie Lewis. Looking to throw, has a man, and the ball is knocked away. Pass intended for Eggleston. Nice defensive play by Jimmy Nelms, along with number 25, Ben Jesse. Bart Bradley back to punt for Sam Houston.
Bart Bradley is the punt.
A.J. Johnson deep for Southwest Texas. And the ball will roll and will be downed. I don't know. The Bearcats think that one of the Bobcats touched the football. Referee says no. And Southwest Texas will take over first and 10.
I believe they're going to mark the ball back at about the 23-yard line because I think it hit a Bearcat player, if anybody, when the ball hit. A Bearcat player was blocked into the football, and so they're going to mark it up at about the 22-yard line. So it'll be marked where that Bearcat touched the ball last, and that was back at the 23-yard line, so it'll be first and 10 for the Bobcats, and finally their offensive unit gets on the field.
With 8:06 to go, first quarter of play, and Southwest Texas' Bobcats leading it 7-0 on the 81-yard punt return by A.J. Johnson. The Bobcats come out on offense with Ron Riddleman at quarterback. Richard Gordy is the fullback. Roy Jackson is the tailback. As that time, the pass intended on the far side for number one, Eric Tennessee. Watch him. He's the leading receiver in the Southland Conference. And a flag is down.
Coach Ron Randleman said, Eric Tennessee, best athlete in his position in the conference, no doubt about it. Eric Tennessee, quick feet, great speed, runs great routes, an excellent wide receiver to watch today for Southwest Texas.
That's number one, the senior 3-year letterman from San Antonio Holmes.
We got a penalty on Southwest Texas for holding here on first down, so we're going to march them back. It's going to give them a first and 20 situation. Looked like miscommunication there on that first play. Tennessee ran an in, and Rittman threw it like it was going to be an out.
Well, the Bobcats went with a single back offense to start the game. Now Jackson has checked into the ball game along with number two, Richard Duffy, at the fullback position as the Bobcats go with 3 wideouts. Hand the ball straight up the middle to Duffy. He will have short yardage. Richard Duffy, the junior transfer who attended the University of Arkansas out of Houston Memorial, gets the carry for Southwest Texas.
It's going to be tough for Southwest Texas to run on that fine Bearcat defensive line, and they are a good one up there with Marvin Brown, Mike Ober, Huey Blackman, and Andre Finley. It's tough to run on those guys.
So the Southwest Texas offense making many switches. They're bringing in about three people with every play. As Mike Murphy comes to the near side of the field and Eric Tennessee, far side, run the draw play to 34. That's Richard Gordy, the sophomore one-year letterman from Georgetown, and he gets just back to the line of scrimmage.
And a good play there by Andre Finley, shedding off his blocker and making the good ankle tackle there. Short yards for Southwest Texas. Credit that play to Finley because of his reactions that helped a short gain. They could have gotten more yards if it wasn't for Finley on that.
Andre Finley, Sam Houston's leading sack man, the sophomore one-year letterman from Houston Forest Brook, having an outstanding season from that strong end position. Now the Bobcats will come out, third down and 16, ball at the 15-yard line. Darryl Grant is the receiver to the near side of the field now. Riddiman looking to throw, has a man wide open, and the ball is caught. That's 32, Reggie Rivers. And that time, Rivers split the seam, and he was wide open.
Looked like they had the linebacker coverage on him. Tolly Royal, also Donnie Balthauser, looked like they had coverage on him. And he was just wide open on the play, went right by him for the catch and the first down for Southwest Texas.
So spot the ball up to the 45-yard line, first and 10 Southwest Texas, as they are now moving the ball on offense as Mark Murphy and Eric Tennessee both come to the near side of the field, I formation behind the quarterback Ron Riddiman. Hand the ball up to the tailback, that's Roy Jackson. Give him a gain of about 1 yard on the play, and it'll bring up a second down and 9.
Good play there by Mike Ober. Had to come from the opposite side of his position. Was playing on the left side. The play went to the right side. Mike Ober's got those quick feet where he can get over and go to the opposite side and get the ball carrier. Good play by Ober to get Jackson on that.
So, second down and 10. Officially no gain on that last run by Jackson as Eric Tennessee comes to the near side and Mike Murphy goes wide to the far side. One back set for Southwest now. Riddiman looking to throw, has Tennessee, and he will be brought down. Lloyd Powell with help from Ricky Royal, and he will be close to the first down. I think he has it.
Good call there by John O'Hara. Just a quick little in there to Eric Tennessee. Lloyd Powell, also Ricky Royal playing a little bit back. You don't want Tennessee to burn you on a deep play down the sidelines. And so that play might be open for Southwest Texas, a good part of the game today. Tennessee is close to the first down. They're going to bring the sticks out. We're going to bring it all the way across the field and see if we got the first down. I think you might be right, Rod. I'm right on top of it. I think he got it by about three quarters of the football. And he did.
And it will be first and 10.
Half the football.
About half.
About half.
About half the football, the length on the first down. 5:27 to go. First quarter of action, Bobcat Stadium in San Marcos as Jackson, Roy Jackson, the tailback, and 34 Richard Gordy check into the ball game.
45, Bobcats, first and 10.
So the Bobcats moving the ball well as Murphy and Tennessee both go to the far side of the field. I formation, Gordy and Jackson behind the quarterback Riddiman. Now rolling out, looking to throw, has a man. That's Eric Tennessee. He is hit and brought down, but once again, a nice catch by the senior three-year letterman from San Antonio Holmes.
Well, it's no doubt who Ron Rittman's number one receiver he's going to be going to all afternoon is Eric Tennessee. Had triple coverage on that time, just a good throw by Rittman, a good catch by Tennessee. First and 10, not at the 28, but it's at the 33-yard line. Southwest Texas moving the ball in their first possession here in the first quarter. Got a touchdown by the gift of the punt return by A.J. Johnson. They're up 7-0. They're trying to go in 14-0 right here.
Murphy and Tennessee are both split to the left side. I formation behind Riddiman, first and 10, ball at the 33-yard line. Bearcat defense looks a little confused here in the early going. Hand it off, Roy Jackson, watch him. He's got speed across the 20-yard line to about the 18-yard line. Hit on the play by 31, Charles Livingston, a defensive back. Brings him down with another first down for Southwest Texas.
It was a trap play. You trap it, you give it to the running back. The blockers pull one way and hope you get the defensive lineman, the sucker, to go the same way, and that's what happened there. The lineman pulled, the two guards pulled along with the center, and when that happened, the defensive lineman suckered away and went that way, and when that happened, Roy Jackson had a big hole and got a first down for the Bobcats.
So Charles Livingston is in now at the defensive back, replacing Meldon Mickles. First and 10, spot the ball at the 18-yard line. Hand it to the tailback, that's Jackson. And a good surge by the defensive line. 98, Mike Ober helps to make the stop on Jackson. It'll be a second down and 9. So the clock runs with 3 minutes, 50 seconds to go. First quarter, Bearcats trailing at 7-0. Southwest Texas has the ball deep in Sam Houston territory. As Tennessee comes wide to the left side and Mike Murphy goes wide to the right. Single back with a slot to the left side. Riddiman now looking to throw, has a man open. That's Murphy, far side of the field, brought down by Lloyd Powell, but he will still be about 5 or 6 yards short of the first down.
Primary wide receiver on that play was Murphy, because Rittman was looking at him all the way from the snap of the football. Just a short gain. You try to get it up to about a third and four, and then you're being able to mix up what you want to do. You could run it or you could throw it. Probably Southwest Texas will try to throw it here because it's hard to run on the Bearcats, especially with a third down, more than 3 yards to go.
So now a big play for Sam Houston. That's 85. Scott Wilson checks into the ball game at a tight end position. Eric Tennessee is in a slot to the left side. Mike Murphy is wide left. Now Riddiman looking to throw. And the ball is almost intercepted. Ricky Royal and Lloyd Powell on the coverage. Pass intended for Mike Murphy.
Pass was a little bit high for Murphy, but a good play by Royal and Powell to hit Murphy just as the ball got there. He had to reach up, and when he grabbed it, Lloyd Powell and Royal hit him right as the ball got there and knocked it loose. So a good stand by the Bearcats. They let him get down to inside the 15-yard line. But then the Bearcat defense held, and now a 32-yard field goal here by Matlock.
Matlock out of the hold of David Haas, has the wind behind him. Kick is up on its way, and it is no good. No good. So Kyle Matlock, the sophomore from Spring, Texas, fails to get the field goal attempt through. Big play that time for Sam Houston, and now they get the ball back with only with 2 minutes, 46 seconds. If they can keep the ball and maybe get a couple of first downs on the ground, maybe they could get that wind here on this drive.
That was a big miss there by Matlock. Good offensive possession there by Southwest Texas. He had the wind behind him, so that wasn't much of a factor. The kick was from the left hash mark. He may have thought a little bit about, I can't hook this ball. If I hook it a little bit, it's gonna be wide left. That may have been on his mind. Usually your left-handed kickers, left-footed kickers, like to hook the ball a little bit, and that may have been what happened on that kick as he pulled it left.
Hand the ball to Luther Turner. He will have short yardage, about 2 yards on the play.
Number 33, rather, Luther Turner on the carry.
We got two more needs to talk about here before we finally get them out of the way. 19 yards is the most total yards by an individual in a season, which was by Don Gottlob in 1952, a team record. It was 2,470. Reggie had 2,452. He needs 19 for that. Billy Anderson needs 2 interceptions to break school record of 7 on the year.
Second and 8. Pitchback goes. Luther Turner, watch him. He turns the corner, puts the move on. He's across midfield to the 40 and run out of bounds over here on the near sideline by number 19. That's Jimmy Nelms. As the referees will say, just at the 40-yard line. Big run that time as Luther Turner, when he gets to the corner, he's dangerous.
I'd like to comment on it, Rod, but here comes the train. I'm not going to be able to get a word in edgewise, so listen to the beautiful train coming by Bobcat Stadium.
First and 10. Ball at the 40-yard line. Fullback James Shorts on the carry. He will have about 3 yards on that play. Close to 4 yards. Give him 4 yards on the carry and bring up a second down and 6.
Bearcats would like to see that clock run out. 1:40 to go in the first quarter. Get that clock running. Try to run out the time so the Bearcats get the win in the second quarter.
Victor Henry is the lone wide receiver out to the left side. Pitch it back to the tailback. That's Ricky Davis, who has checked into the ball game now. The freshman from Fort Worth, Everman. He will bring the ball across the 35-yard line to the 33, so he will be about 2 yards short of the first down. And you're right, Jim, Bearcats trying to milk that clock down and perhaps turn it around and get the win here on this possession. But if they're going to do that, as Turner checks back into the ballgame, they're going to have to pick up this third and two call. Double tight end set, Beecham tight to the left, Ricky Eggleston tight to the right, I formation, Turner in shorts. Victor Henry is the lone receiver to the left side. Pitch it back deep in the backfield to Turner, puts a head down and gets out across the 30-yard line. He will have the first down, tackle on the play by Andre Horton.
Just good hard running by Luther Turner. They like to bring it around to that right side. Good blocking there by the right side of the offensive line. Turner got the first down. The clock will continue to run. Under 38 seconds to go in the first quarter. They could run one more running play, and then they got that win in the second quarter.
So James Lopez now goes wide to the left side as the Bearcats stay with the double tight end alignment. Clock now under 30 seconds to go. First quarter of play. Hand the ball straight up the middle. Luther Turner is popped. He will get about a yard on that play. But that very well could be and should be the last play of the first quarter. And the Bearcats, barring, or if you look past that punt return for the touchdown, Bearcats playing a fairly decent first half, but Southwest Texas did move the ball well.
It wasn't a bad quarter for the Bearcats. They moved the ball on the ground, which is a hard thing to do against Southwest Texas because, they stacked that defensive line. They put just about everybody they can, except for the cornerbacks and the safeties, up on the line. We knew it would be hard going into the game to run against Southwest Texas, but they did so successfully, just couldn't get the key third down plays. Third down and long, it's hard to throw into that win. The only touchdown, the punt return by A.J. Johnson. You say 81 yards officially for the touchdown. But the Bearcats now will have the win in the second quarter. Bearcats, I don't even have to have a stat chart to figure this out. Had no yards passing in the first quarter. That will definitely change in the second. Look for Reggie to air it out
that's
in the second quarter. The offense will open up a lot more.
That's what I was going to ask you, Jim. You think you're going to all of a sudden see Bearcats. And you can tell right away, Rob Beecham checks out of the ball game. The Bearcats will now come out of that double tight end running formation. They will switch to the single tight end double wide receiver passing formation. And as you mentioned, Jim, the Bearcats probably will open it up here as they now have the win.
Now we will see a good example of the high-scoring multiple offense at Sam Houston State University.
James Lopez is into the ballgame. He split wide to the left side. Keith Willis is wide to the right. I formation. Shorts and Turner are the setbacks. Tight end Ricky Eggleston is tight to the left side. Second and 10. Ball at the 29-yard line. Now fake the handoff. Reggie Lewis turns it upfield, and he will be brought down. He will gain about 3 yards on the play. Tackled by Todd Davis, sophomore squadsman from Abilene Wiley.
What makes Reggie so deadly on that play is you got to watch him. It's a naked roll. Looked like he was looking for the tight end on the play. The tight end was well covered, but Reggie can always tuck that ball and run with it. That's why he's such a versatile quarterback. If you drop back and cover the tight end and the receivers, he'll burn you for about 10, 15, maybe 20 yards.
Big play for the Bearcats. Third down and 8. Lewis looking to throw, has a man. That's Lopez wide open. He will be close. He should have, with forward progress, should have enough for the first down.
He will have enough for the first down, Rod. Good throw by Reggie. His first really throw of the day with that win. You got to be careful, you know, with that wind behind you. You have a tendency maybe to throw it a little bit high over the head, but he threw it right where the 9 is, with a little white spot right between it. Hit James Lopez. Lopez is a fine receiver. Wasn't getting much